Hey, everybody. Happy and Merry Christmas to you. We're so excited about our 3ABN Christmas special and to be in your home with you. Today, we have Mr. Tim Parton with us on piano, the most wonderful piano player in the world.
In the room.
He's the best piano player in the room today and in the world,
too. And we're excited to be here, and we're going to take a stroll down memory lane with some of our favorite songs that we've done over the years. And we want to share them with you today as well. And we hope you're having a great Christmas so far and that you're feeling the sights and sounds and you're getting ready for Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
And so we're going to start with some songs that
we're
love.
We're
getting ready. But you know what? First, we want to do another song, Reggie, that you just wrote recently that we put on our new Christmas record. Tell them about that song.
Okay. You know what? How about we just sing a chorus of it?
Okay.
That special time of year when friends and family gather near and celebrate together and make memories we'll remember forever. That special time of year when hugs are warm and we can hear those bells out in the distance. Everyone loves this
special time of year.
And I love this special time of year. I love Christmas. I think of so many things with our parents growing up, with our siblings, the good things, some of the fights. No, I think of so many wonderful things. And I just remember the first time being away from home and coming back home for Christmas, how great that felt.
Like being away at college or
something.
Yes,
I do remember that. And I just love, it matters. No matter what is going on in the world, somehow humanity comes back and it's some of its best. It's some of
right.
our finest moments, I think.
It surely
and so,
is.
Some of the older songs that we grew up with, like Carol of the Bells and I Heard the Bells on Christmas Day.
I love those.
And we just recently did that here at 3ABN and we want to share that with you now.
Bells all seem to say, throw cares away.
Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold.
Ding dong, ding dong, that is our song with joyful ring, all caroling.
One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they pound, raising the sound, o'er hill and dale, telling the tale, gaily they ring. How people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas. I heard the bells on Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play, and wild and sweet the songs repeat of peace on earth, goodwill.
Hate is strong and bold.
Oh my goodness, Lady Love, that took a tremendous amount of air. You hit an out-of-sight note on the end of that thing.
And I'm so glad we did it there and not now.
Whew,
we got it
tough.
Done.
I was completely out of air by the end of that thing. That was a beautiful arrangement that our dear friend Larry Hall put together, and it was just beautiful. And thank you, Larry, for that. Lady Love, first of all, I want to tell you that we're going to be doing a lot of different genres of music today. And just as Lady spoke about earlier, we're going to just take in a ride, a stroll down memory lane.
That's right.
And we're going to actually reach back from some Christmases past on 3ABN and pull
the
those.
Archives.
We're going to reach deep into the archives.
Yes.
And pull some of those other when we were much younger.
Uh-oh.
And we're going to do some actually play some of those too and introduce those to you for sure.
Yes.
This is one of those songs that we're going to reach back in the archive not too long ago. But I want to tell you about this. This was a song that I heard from an old classic singer. His name was Bing Crosby.
Oh, yes.
And Rosemary Clooney.
That's right.
To me, one of the greatest female singers ever. And Bing Crosby, who never really considered himself as a really great singer, was amazing. And they sang this song talking about blessings. Instead of counting sheep, count your blessings.
That's right.
And fall fast asleep. And it goes like this.
When I'm worried and I can't sleep. I count my blessings instead of sheep, and I fall fast asleep, counting my blessings. And when my bankroll is getting small, I think of when we had none at all, and I fall fast asleep, counting my blessings. I think about a nursery, and I picture curly heads, and one by one I count them as they slumber in their beds. So, if you're worried and you can't sleep, just count your blessings instead of sheep, and you'll fall fast asleep, counting your blessings. If you're worried and you can't sleep, just count your blessings instead of sheep, and you'll fall fast asleep, counting your blessings.
count your blessings.
Reggie, I love that song. I've always loved hearing you sing it and love you playing it. And I love that time when we were just sitting around the piano and thinking back to that. I just love it. Such a great message. And even in the secular world, they were realizing that it's better to count your blessings instead of sheep. You know, to not focus on those things and to count. And, you know, we were talking about it the other day, that I was having a time that I was going through. I was upset about something and just stressed about it. And I couldn't think of anything but that thing. And I was driving down the road and I looked out and I just turned everything off and got quiet. And I said, thank you, God, for the grass. Thank you for the sun. Thank you for the... I started counting my blessings instead of sheep. And instead of sheep and instead of worrying, instead of trying to fix it myself. And I became grateful and I started praising Him. And it just changed my whole perspective. And I realized it's out of my control. And I'm just going to count those blessings. And God's going to get us through it. And that's what He's going to do for you today in this season. Because sometimes this season's joyous, but it's also hard. And He's going to get you through whatever you're going through when you count your blessings. So just when you feel like you can't hold on another minute, or you feel like things are getting crazy, or you don't have everything ready for the dinner, or you don't have your stuff ready for everybody coming over, just take a moment, pause, and count your blessings. Tell God, thank you so much for what you're doing. And I'm telling you, He'll put you in a perspective, a totally different perspective. You'll be gratified. You'll be grateful. And guess what? The real reason for the season will return for you just like that. It'll just be, you'll realize what you're here for and not all that anxiety and that stress. Count your blessings. I love that. And you know, another favorite song of mine growing up was Silent Night. And I loved it. Growing up, we would have like every year, all the different community church, all the churches in the community, we would come together and we would have a Christmas Eve service. And we would sing hymns and we would sing Christmas carols. And I do remember we would sing Silent Night. And I was so excited because I had learned a little bit of German. And I had done Silent Night, Stille Nacht, Heilige Nacht. And that's about all I can remember of it. That's all I can remember. But I loved it and I thought that was so cool. And we would sing that. And I have a great memory with a friend of mine who's no longer here. But he was one of my classmates. We would sing that together on that Christmas Eve. And then we liked it so much that we decided to record it just recently.
But before you say that, I was going to say something. You were talking about some memories. We had memories when I was growing up in church. My daddy would be the music minister and mama would play the piano and organ. And we would do a cantata. Remember those cantatas in the book, the music, and a lot of the choir cantatas. You remember a lot of those, don't you, Tim? And I remember that was always a big time for our church. And we would do the Christmas cantata, and then we would go out and then sing in the community to the shut-ins, people who couldn't get out.
Christmas caroling.
Christmas caroling, right. Yes. But the most important thing, and it's always a big thing, chocolate's a big old thing in our household, you guys. Our household and my household growing up, because I got to tell you this. Well, there's some good chocolate, too. The dark chocolate's pretty
there's
good.
There's carob, and there's cacao, and then there's the bad kind that's good, too.
Right, but I got to tell you this. We would end up, we always ended up every year at the Norris house.
Yes.
The Norrises would have this dark chocolate waiting for us, okay, with a hot cup of cocoa at the end of the day, end of the night. So after the choir would sing the special, and we'd let out church, and then we would go caroling to everyone who couldn't make it to church. And we'd end up at the Norris house. So we would end up singing the next song you're going to introduce.
You know what, Reggie? I was very honored to get to go to the Norrises with
you
when
did.
We were dating, or
That's
just
right.
as we were just married, I
That's
think
right.
it was. And I got to meet them, and they were so great. Didn't they do a lot of, didn't they foster children?
Fostered many, many children.
Fostered many Absolutely. Children. And I remember we were in that little back mm-hmm. of their porch, and she had all this little stuff made out. And she said, come on in. And
get amazing. Some. They were amazing.
They were really a precious couple that God used so much because they were willing to be used. And I know for you as a child that you have great memories of them, and I think lots of children have great memories because of them. And speaking of children, Silent Night is one of our favorite songs. It always has been. Now it's even more special to me as a mom, as a mother, because we recently recorded a new Christmas CD. And on this song, Silent Night, we had a special guest. And you can tell them about our son, Brett.
And I got to tell you, we brought him into the studio. And, of course, Brett has grown up in the studio and around mics, even as a baby, sleeping under a microphone through the nighttime. And he's an only child, so he was around it all the time and traveled with us all the time. But we asked him, said, Brett, we would love for you to sing on one of the songs, maybe Silent Night. And he said, hey, Dad, that's all fine and dandy. I've got 15 minutes right here in this time in my schedule. I said, so if you could give me that 15 minutes in your schedule, run by the studio. I'll be ready for you. We'll cut your vocal, and you can go on with your friends, and you go about your...
And honestly, he's an introvert, and we're both very extroverted, so he kind of keeps us in line. He's more the technical one. He does our teleprompters and does our music and our product tables when we're on the road. So he's not as outgoing in that. So when we did this recording recently, I think he was a bit nervous, to be honest. He was nervous.
He did great.
But he did. But on the recording, you liked it because you said it reminded you.
Well, he reminded me of Dierks Bentley. So he came in and he's grown up now. He's got this, he's a 21-year-old, and he's got this grown voice, and it's it's not real clear like it used to be when he was a little boy and he sang Thank You Lord on 3ABN many times, you know, with that clear high boy soprano voice, and now it's a deeper man voice, and it was kind of rough and wasn't clear. So mother came in and said, honey, let me get you some hot tea and we'll clear that voice up real well. I said, you're not touching it. That's magic. That's fantastic. And it goes well.
So this song is very special to us because it's kind of part of our family. It's with our son, Brett, Silent Night.
Lady, I love that classic. Silent
Well, of course, I love it because our son was on it.
Yeah, well, yeah.
But Mama. It is a great song, and I love some of the older classic songs. Yeah. And we're going to do some more here in a medley called the King's Medley. And some of the songs we went caroling with and some of the songs that you probably know and can sing along with us right now.
In those days, that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day, the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
Away in a manger, no crib for a babe, the down his sweet head, the stars in the sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay.
back to that first Christmas. Can you imagine it? It was just an ordinary day. They thought an ordinary baby has been born. But can you imagine the 9 months before? Can you imagine the months leading up to that? How Mary must have felt. She was just a young girl. She was a young girl like maybe you. She was a young girl like I was, with hopes and dreams. And how could she even imagine that she would carry the Christ child? And that she would do that willingly, knowing that she could be ridiculed. Knowing that people would have no idea, because this has never happened, obviously, before or never again. How could she know what was about to happen?
He was just an ordinary baby. That's the way he planned it. Maybe anything less than common would have kept him apart from the children that he came to rescue, limited to some elite few. When he was the only child who asked to be born, and he came to us with eyes wide open, knowing how we're hurt and broken, choosing to partake of all our joy and pain. He was just an ordinary baby. That's the way he planned it, maybe, so that we could come to him and not be afraid.
He was ordinary with exception of miraculous conception. Both his birth and death he planned from the start. But between his entrance and his exit was a life that has affected everyone who's walked the earth to this very day.
He became God's pure extension, giving you and me the chance to be remade. He was just an ordinary baby. That's the way maybe, so that we could come to him and not be afraid.
So that we could come to him and not be afraid. Thank you.
What a beautiful song written by our friend Miss Gloria Gaither. She is so, so gifted, Lady Love, when she writes a lyric.
Yes, she is. And God has given her such a gift to bring out His word and to write it with such beautiful colors and imagery.
Oh, my goodness. It's so beautiful. And we want to do another traditional carol. What Child Is This?
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing.
What child is this? I love that, Reggie. What child is this? I can imagine that Mary was asking herself some of these same questions. How could she know, as we said before, the brevity and the magnitude of what was about to happen and what she was involved in and how she, this whole thing, the child that she was delivering, would soon deliver us all. How could she know all of these things? Mary, did you know?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will someday walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy come to make you new, and this child that you've delivered will soon deliver you? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy calm a storm with his hand? have kissed the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praise is out.
Lady Love, what a song for the ages. Our two good friends,
right,
Mark Lowry and Buddy Green, both collaborated and wrote that. Buddy,
that's right.
Mark wrote the lyric.
And Buddy did the music.
And Buddy did the music.
That's
and
right.
What a perfect combination.
And how incredible is it? I was thinking about that song. It's such a just an iconic song for all time. That God, you know, we know them, so we know them as normal people, as, you know, we know them everyday life. And I think about how God used those people to write that song aloud, gave them that song, that responsibility. And, you know, he does that for all of us. If we're willing to be used, he will use us in spite
right.
of anything
Absolutely.
In our lives. He will use us.
Of all our junk, right?
That's right.
Of all our junk. And Lady Love, I want to hear you sing. We're going to do a package of about three songs here. And the first one will be Love in Any Language.
Oh.
I love this one. Are you going to sing in a different language on that?
I'm going to try.
Just a little bit,
yeah.
Right, right. What
yeah.
language would you be singing?
I don't know. We'll wait.
We'll
see
what happens. Okay. And they're also
French, Russian, a little bit of everything.
French and Russian. Okay.
Yes.
And English too, right? Okay. So I'll know what's going on. And also, Let There Be Peace.
Yeah.
We'll sing a little bit of that song. And then one of my all-time favorites, you have so many that are all my all-time favorites that you sing, is Grown Up Christmas List. So we'll just put this package of three songs together, and I hope you enjoy it. Love in Any Language. Could you sing just a bit of that?
And for all the people watching in Russia and all these countries that I'm about to sing your language, don't laugh because it's not accurate. But it's for you, and it says like this.
Je t'aime, te amo, ya tibia le blu, ani ya hevr aka. I love you. The sounds are all as different as the lands from which they came. And though our worlds are all unique, our hearts are still the same. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls us all together.
And there is a song that is so powerful to me, Lady Love, that you sing, Let There Be Peace. And I just think that's such a powerful, powerful message.
I love it because we have a lot of friends also that are family to us all over the world.
Yes.
And you know, I want peace for everyone. Mm. And this is such a universal promise and the thing that we want for everyone,
yes.
especially now.
Thank you. with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. There's another song I love, especially right now in this time in our country and in the world. And you know, it doesn't matter how old we are, we have wishes and we hope for the world and for our children. And I'd like to sing this last song. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men."
Sweet. They made you be born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, didn't know who you was, didn't know you'd come to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Our eyes was blind, we couldn't see, and we didn't know who you was. Was born in a manger, Lord. Sweet little Jesus boy, the world it treat you mean, Lord, treat me mean too, but forgive us, Lord. And we didn't know that it was you. So sweet, little Jesus boy, ago, sweet little holy child, and we didn't know who you Oh my goodness, this has been so much fun. Timothy, thank you so much for being part of this. Your skills are second to none,
and
we're grateful.
Thanks for letting me be a part of you guys. It's always fun to be. I love you as my friends. Thank you.
You know what? We love you as our friend, too. We love to be professional and make music together, but we love just hanging out more than anything else. So, and Lady Love, this has been such a great, great day. And sharing with you and sharing the hope and the light of the world. Jesus is the King. He came as a little baby boy, and he's the King. And that's pretty amazing. That's pretty powerful. Lady Love, there's a song that I love to hear you sing, another one. I'm going to pull this on you. Get in the key of C. Are you in the key of C? Key of C, and I want you to sing the chorus. You can just do the chorus of Bethlehem Morning. Now, it's been a minute. Do you remember the key of college? Because I haven't done it since college.
Oh, my
goodness. It's been a minute. But you can remember the chorus, I think. Bethlehem Morning. Okay.
Bethlehem Morning is more than just a memory for the child that was born there, has come to set us free. Bethlehem sunrise, I can see him in your eyes. For the child that was born there is the King of Kings and the Lord of Yeah.
That's what I remembered in college days for sure. That was beautiful. You know what? What a wonderful, wonderful time. And we've talked about it many times that the Christmas time is sometimes the most joyful time. But sometimes it's not joyful to someone who's just lost a loved one, lost your mate, lost your friend or a child. And it's really hard times. It can be a very depressing time. But Jesus loves you more than you can ever, ever imagine. And he came to be the King and the light of this world. And he said he will never leave us nor forsake you. And he is right there with you in that room right now. So please be encouraged and know that you are loved by the one that we've been talking about and singing about all day today.
And you know, Reggie, all the time when we talk to people, when we go on social media or we're talking to people, what is the thing we always say at the very end that you say?
You are loved.
And please remember that. You're loved by us. You're loved by God. You're loved by your family here at 3ABN. And the last thing we would like to do is one more song. It's an old song.
Well, before you do that, I just want to say we love our 3ABN family. We're grateful for Danny and Jill and Greg and Yvonne and the whole team. They're second to none behind the scenes. If you just knew all the work that was going on behind the scenes, the editors.
The care and the excellence.
And the love and the care, that's right, and the excellence. Love and the care behind the scenes that people you will never see in front of the cameras that are really doing the work. They're behind the cameras, behind the sound boxes and all the video and everything. It's just incredible. All the lighting and all the set. It's just incredible what goes on 24 hours a day here at 3ABN all over the world so people can hear the message and the promise and to hear about Jesus, the light of the world. And he's got you. He's got you all the way. And Lady Love, before we leave, we've got about a minute and change left here.
And I want to say something. Yeah. This is a song that's special to me because my daddy and I used to always sit around with his guitar and we would play this song. And like you said, all the way at the beginning of this program, when I would come home from college, I couldn't wait. Because when I was getting ready to do those exams or I was sad or I was missing everybody, I'd think, I'll be home for Christmas soon. And I love this song and that message.
I'll be home for Christmas. You can plan on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents under the tree. Eve will find me where